Welcome to Town Lake at Fireman's Park. With me today is Commissioner Veronica Whitacre, and we're here to discuss Commissioner's Corner and see what's going on in your district.
My district's always exciting, so I'm proud to represent my district. I think we've come a long way, and I think that my constituents feel comfortable enough to call me, or even call when they call me and I say, call the city, call this number. We do have a 311 app, which is so useful for the entire city of McAllen, and people do use it. It's an amazing app. You can download it on your phone, and the 311 app will tell you if you've got brush problems, if you've got electricity problems, water problems, whatever your concern might be at that point. If you do the 311 app, it'll answer, it'll call you back, it will text you back an answer, it will text back some information as to what is going to take place, and if they do need to communicate with you, they will communicate with you and say, please call us. It's a wonderful app for all of you to use. It's 311 and you can download it on your phone. So that's one of my main that I'm very, very proud of, because again, it brings communication within our city, within my district, and that way we can actually hold conversation. So.
And of course, the McAllen 311 app is available on the Apple Store, and it's also in Google Play, and it's free. And as the commissioner said, as soon as you log in and you put your issue, it goes directly to the department that's responsible
for it. That is correct.
So it has been incredible for the city.
It has. It's a wonderful tool that we've created, yes.
Well, we're here at the beautiful Town Lake at Firemen's Park,
which is part of my community, which is part of my district. And Town Lake, if you haven't been out here, has improved tremendously. We, of course, during the summer, we have kayaking, we have wadeboarding, catch and release. We have events here. You're more than welcome to come out and rent the Fireman's Park pump house. You can rent the pavilion. Every Saturday from probably August to May, we have farmers market out here from 8 a.m. until about 11, and our farmers market has improved dramatically. There's lots of people here by 8 a.m. You can pass by, and the parking lot is full. And so we're very, very fortunate that they've chosen Fireman's Park in the city of McAllen. Not only do we have Fireman's Park, but we also, of course, have the McAllen Public Library. So we do accommodate the north and the south side of the city of McAllen. So another added addition to my area.
And something that you kicked off here at this park that I'm going to sort of brag for you is your Book Nook.
I did.
Free books.
I do have free books. And Barnes & Noble has been very, very generous to us also. And so when my Book Nooks are, low, I do have quite a few boxes stored away to refill those books. You're more than welcome to come to Fireman's Park, Los Encinos Park, Bill Shoup, La Vista, and even we have one at Alvarez Elementary. And what that does is that we are putting children's books, adult books, any type of reading that is available, we'll put those books in there. You can bring a book from your home, you can fill them up for us if you do see them empty, and then you can take. So it's an open public library, and it works.
And it's sharing.
It's sharing. Oh, yeah, it's sharing. And a lot of kids have projects. Your high school kids have a project. They have to read a book, and do a report and a whole poster board and do a presentation. So if you're not able to go to the library, or you're not able to go to Barnes & Noble or find it online, drop by one of your parks and go ahead and pick one up.
And I have seen parents who are either doing one of the activities here, they'll go grab a book for their kids so they can read at the park.
The ones who have taken advantage of those are your homeschoolers. On Thursday mornings, it is park day. Most of the parks are filled with homeschoolers on Thursday mornings. And so they are now able to reach out to our Book Nooks, take a book, read a book, put it back, bring a book. And so again, it is wonderful sharing, an opportunity for those kids who, again, aren't able to go to the library, have an opportunity to go to a Book Nook and pick up a book. So those are good things.
Another big cause that you're sort of spearheading is the city's Run, Ride, and Share campaign. Tell us a little bit about that and what's going on.
Run, Ride, and Share started in April of 2014. So we were very, very excited about the Run, Ride, and Share program. And what we are doing is we're running, we're riding, and we're sharing the road. You see a lot of people out at Fireman's Park. You see a lot of people out in the community walking with their families, with those strollers, with their kids. A lot of parents who are teaching their kids how to ride a bike. They're using our trails when our trails go, all around the city. And for those of you who don't know, we're also adding a second pedestrian bridge over on Bicentennial. So if you're on Bicentennial and need to get to the neighborhood across Bicentennial, we're going to have a second pedestrian bridge. So all of that is for all of us to stay moving, to stay healthy, and to move on to the city of McAllen. But Run, Ride, and Share was adopted and started in April of 2014, and we have learned to do bike rodeos in schools. We've done bike rodeos at UTRGV. We've done bike rodeos at the different hospitals during your trauma expo centers. We've been all over. We've been to San Antonio. We've been to Austin already. TxDOT has adopted our program, which is wonderful. When Michelle Obama was in office with her husband, Barack, then what we had was called Let's Move Cities. McAllen was the only all-star city nationwide, and due to the fact that Run, Ride, and Share was a great component of that, because we got people moving, biking, running, walking, and out in the community because of the Run, Ride, and Share program. And what we're trying to do is educate those who are running, riding, or on the road. You know, remember, don't text and drive. Remember, try to focus while you're driving. And because it's right on red, doesn't mean you just cruise through the red light and turn right. No, we need to be cautious. If you're out cycling or you're out walking during the evening, remember to wear some type of reflector so that you can be seen. Even though the light says, the little hand says you can go across, make sure that you don't have 6 seconds left, because the person that is coming might not realize that you have 6 seconds and there's a fatality or a casualty. So Run, Ride, and Share, again, we're trying to educate the community to be respectful of one another while you're on the road. So if you see a sign that says Run, Ride, and Share, run, ride, and share the road.
And I know that with those bike rodeos, what's important is you teach the kids early on about road safety rules.
That is correct.
Because just like people on cyclists that are on the road, motorists also have to know what they're doing.
That is correct. That is correct. And that's why I say, if you're out, you know, and you know you're going to be out beyond dark, or you run at 6 o'clock in the morning, wear your reflectors so that people can see you. And there's, you know, our kids are our best educators. Your kids will tell you, Mom, pay attention. Not that I remember that, but your kids do tell you, Mom, please pay attention. Mom, the light is red. Mom, there's a person walking across the street. And once you sit in that car, your child is the first one to say, buckle up, Mom, please. So our kids are our greatest educators.
And I know you, in your bike rodeos, at times you're able to give bike helmets to young kids.
We do.
For going through the short little program of safety.
That is correct. And anytime you're on the road, regardless if you're on the trail, regardless if you're on the streets, no matter where you are while you're cycling, not because we're trying to tell you to prevent that somebody, you know, you might, you know, fall down, but concussions, even if you just fall over, you just fall just the right way, you know, you need to protect your head.
Okay, another thing that you're super involved with is the McAllen Marathon.
I am.
And you've participated several times.
I have.
Tell us about what's going on with that.
I've done the half, and I tell everybody, you know, just because you think, oh my God, she can move, I can move. And I love to move. I am very involved. Our McAllen Marathon is growing. It's going to be in January again this year, and it's a wonderful time of the year to run. Of course, you don't want to be running in 98 degree weather. It's a little warm, and it's tasking on your body if it's that warm. But our marathon, we're going to have a 5K, a 10K, the kids marathon, so that we can get children involved, because our kids, we started the 1 mile last weekend over at the stadium, and so our children have an opportunity to run a marathon. They don't have to run that marathon all at one time as we do as adults or even as teenagers, but these children are able to track their mileage throughout the next 3 or 4 months, and they get their parents involved, they get their community involved, they get their classmates involved, their teachers involved, because they have to track those miles. What better way to get McAllen moving than through your kids? Again, who's our best educator? I my hat's off to all the educators in the city of McAllen and the McAllen Independent School District, but your kids are number one, because they'll correct you faster than anybody else. So you're more than welcome as a child to start your McAllen Marathon, you know, Kids Marathon, and you can run from now until January and complete your mile at the marathon. If you haven't signed up for the marathon and you haven't trained, it's not too late. About 8 weeks is probably a perfect time to train, and you can do couch to marathon, and they do have that app also on your phone, and you can Google it, look it up, to learn how to train properly, and run the McAllen Marathon with us. And I do encourage people to get out and move. If you're not able to do a half a marathon or a full marathon, do a relay team. My relay team name is Bad News Bears, and we are Bad News Bears because, you know, we can do it.
And I know with the Kids Marathon, people can register their child.
Yes, they can.
And they win a medal at the end. And
it's a beautiful medal.
And what's great about our community is that the city partnered up with the school district.
They did.
Because without my MISD and the city working together, how do you get thousands of kids to participate?
And not only this kid, the school district, UTRGV, Texas A&M, Rio Grande Regional Hospital, we have great sponsors that are encouraging our community to stay healthy. And that's also so very important. And you don't have to be rail thin to be healthy. And you don't have to be, if you are rail thin, you think you're healthy, it's just all about exercise, moving, making sure that you make the right choices, and to be active.
I know last year I met some parents who literally had done the marathon miles with their kids, because even though the kids were earning points in their gym class,
right,
the parents felt, I'm going to go help you and let's go do a lap, or let's walk around the block, or let's do something active to sort of encourage their kids to continue.
And that's good. And that time with your child also gets you conversation. And you learn from your children. You don't even have to, you know, you get in the car and they get, how was school today? Same, Mom. You know, you get that answer. But when you're out walking with them and you see a leaf, they'll tell you what they learned in school, you know, maybe that day, 2 or 3 weeks prior to that day, because they did learn in the science class something about the trees or the environment. And so it's so good to have conversation with your children daily, because that also, it's healthy, it's good for you.
So if you'd like to learn more about the McAllen Marathon, you can go to www.mcallenmarathon.com. And if you want to learn more about the city of McAllen, you can always download the app at your Apple Store or Google Play Store, and it's free. Or you can also go to the city website at McAllen.net. For the city of McAllen, with Commissioner Veronica Whitacre for Commissioner's Corner, thank you very much for joining us.